What's up guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to today's video, which is a little bit different but one that I'm really excited to share with you, and that is an introduction to crystals for beginners. So in today's video there are four particular things that I want to talk about that I found really confusing when I was a beginner and trying to get my head around the world of crystals. And those four things are: how to choose your crystals, how to store them, how to cleanse them, and how to program them, all of which are terms that you will have heard referenced again and again and again when you start researching and looking into crystals, which may not make all that much sense initially. And so I think a quick explanation of what those four things are, alongside an introduction to some of my own crystal collection, will be really helpful when delving into the world of practicing with crystals. And if you do like this video at any point, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, that really helps me out. And don't forget to hit subscribe so that you don't miss any more of my zero waste and earth conscious content. So the first thing that you will notice when you start to research and delve into the world of crystals is the sheer volume of types of crystal, different sizes, different shapes. So how do you know what to pick and what is right for you? So first off, the reason that there are so many different types of crystals is because they are naturally occurring in the earth, which means that crystals are as varied as we are. And there are so many different types depending on where in the world they've come from and how they have been formed. And so for me, when I was looking for my crystals, the way that I did it was to know what I wanted to use my crystals for. So I knew that I wanted to dispel negative energy, work on positivity, work on self-love, work on wealth, not physical wealth, but wealth of knowledge, wealth of spirituality and connection to the world around me. And so there are certain types of crystals that you can use which are more commonly associated with those uses. And what I mean by a certain crystal being more commonly associated with a certain function or a certain intention is, for example, taking amethyst. Amethyst is this absolutely gorgeous purple white crystal, and it is most typically associated with dispelling negative energy. But it can also be used to enhance your intuition by opening up what is called your third eye chakra, which connects us to vision and balance and opens up our minds to new ideas. So those are two different uses or intentions for the same crystal, but many people would know amethyst for its negative energy dispelling properties. So with all that said, the point is that a great way to choose what crystal will work for you is to know what intention you have towards that crystal. A second way to choose your crystal is to actually let it choose you, which sounds a bit strange, but we have natural affinities towards different stones. For example, taking my celestite, which is this absolutely beautiful bluish crystal here. And this crystal is called the angel crystal, and it is associated with calmness, with soothingness, with a connection to a higher power, which may not necessarily be a guardian angel depending what you believe, but it can just mean higher universal powers and connection to positive energy and positive forces that exist out there in the universe. And when I was looking for crystals, I had no idea that I would have an attraction to celestite, but I just think it is so beautiful. I love what it represents. I sleep with this beside my bed on my windowsill, and I like to use it as a sense of guidance when things get tough or stressful and I feel like I need a helping hand. So those are two really nice, really easy ways to know that you are choosing a crystal that is right for you, your intention, and whether you feel drawn to it. And I should also say that there is no right or wrong with what you choose, and there's no right or wrong as to whether you prefer a polished stone or a raw stone. So if I show you my amethyst again, you can see that it is very much in the raw stone format, and I just think that is so gorgeous. It represents the natural environment. Nothing has been done to it by cutting it, and so I am definitely more drawn towards raw stones, but that is a complete personal preference. What do you do when you actually have them in your possession? The first thing is to make sure that you store them correctly. So I store them in a little jewelry box that my nan got me, and it is this beautiful, strong and sturdy glass box with a lovely kind of plush inside that just keeps them really safe, stops them from getting damaged, and also protects them from negative energies from the outside environment. So if I'm not using my crystals or if there's somebody else in the space, I don't want my crystals to be absorbing that negative energy. So this keeps them nice and protected. And a great way to keep them safe if you don't have a box will be to just keep them in a little drawstring bag, just like this. Keeps them separate from each other. In case any of those raw edges would rub off each other, we definitely don't want any breakage or damage. So as a beginner, you may have also heard of cleansing your crystals. And that can be confusing for people because what does it mean? You run them in water, you wash them with soap, who really knows? And what this means is you dispel the negative energies from your crystals. When you use your stones to meditate or for healing purposes, they absorb all of that bad and negative energy. So as you use them, it builds up and builds up and builds up. And so every now and again, whether that's every time you use your crystals, once a week, once a month, depending on how you are using them, you will want to cleanse your crystals to remove that negative energy, reset and recharge your crystal so that you can work well in harmony together. I like to think of this as an act of care for your crystals. And there are so many different ways to cleanse your crystals that it is going to depend completely on personal preference. Again, so a lot of people hold their crystals in running water, whether that's a river or even a tap. Some people bury them in the earth for a couple of hours, but I personally really like to do what is called smudging. And smudging is a method of cleansing your crystals using sage, which is this bundle here. And again, if you're a beginner, you've probably seen this all over the place. And I am going to do a full in-depth video on sage and how it works. But basically what you do is you light your sage with a match or lighter and you would just work with your crystals, preferably outdoors, to dispel that negative energy. And sage is a sacred plant with a multitude of healing properties that has been used throughout the ages. But you don't need this to start out with. You can use those other methods. So if you're worried about what should I buy first, this is a crazy amount of information. Just focus on your crystals and you can work on cleansing second because you don't necessarily need any cleansing equipment. And the last piece of jargon that I'll talk about in this video is you may have heard of programming crystals, which doesn't sound like they should go together. But programming your crystals, it basically means setting an intention for your crystal. So you're basically asking your crystal to do a certain thing for you. And you don't need to be an experienced crystal healer or experienced with crystals to do this effectively. So for example, I have this absolutely stunning rose quartz crystal here. And I chose this crystal because lately I have been trying to manifest a more soothing, more loving, more gentle energy, not just towards other people and the environment, but also towards myself and trying to love myself a little bit more. And so it is an intention that I have programmed this crystal to help me with. And a final thing that I'd like to draw your attention to if you are completely new to crystals is that you will see loads of selenite absolutely everywhere. And it is this absolutely stunning crystal, which is also known as liquid light. And you can see exactly why. It is named after the Greek goddess of the moon, Selene. And it has many, many uses, but mostly helps to stabilize and balance the emotional body, which is something that at times I feel like I need a lot of help with. And so I love to call on selenite to balance the energy in the room, assist with the decision-making, understanding, and insight. And insight often into how I'm feeling and why I am feeling a certain way. So I love to leave my selenite out where I would see it, often on my work desk, just to remind me to stay balanced and stay grounded. All right, everybody, so that is a quick rundown of some of the fundamental basic things that you need to know as a beginner setting out on your journey with crystals. I really hope you found it helpful. If you did, please don't forget to hit subscribe and turn on your notification bell so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. And I'm really looking forward to seeing you back in my next video. Bye.